Indeed, for those who believed in Allah and His Prophet and do good deeds according to the instructions, they will enjoy eternal happiness in gardens of bliss. In paradise, their enjoyment is eternal as fulfillment to Allah's promise, and He never breaks a promise, and He is the Almighty, the All-Wise. Allah has created the heavens without pillars to hold it, and He has created the mountains to stabilize the earth and establish life for humans and creatures. And we sent down water from the heavens to irrigate the land, to promote pairs of everything, beneficial, beautiful, and fruitful for you. All these and more are the creation of Allah. Now show me what your gods created. Truly, the disbelievers are in deep error away from the straight path.
وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَنِ اشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ وَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِابْنِهِ وَهُوَ يَعِظُهُ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ أن اشكر لي ولوالديك إلي المصير وإن جاهداك على أن تشرك بي ما ليس لك به علم فلا تطعهما وصاحبهما في الدنيا معروفا واتبع سبيل من أناب إلي ثم إلي مرجعكم فأنبئكم بما كنتم تعملون.
We had given one of our pious people, Luqman, the wisdom in religion, and fit mind, and saying things straight to the point. And we told him, thank Allah and be grateful, and whomever give thanks, it is only for his own good, and whomever shows ingratitude, then Allah does not need any gratitude. He is free of all needs, worthy of all praise. O Prophet, mention the time when Luqman advised his son, saying, my dear son, never associate partners to Allah. Surely this act of association is grievous wrong and great injustice. We advise the human to be good in respect of his parents, as his mother carried him in pregnancy, weakness over weakness, and his separation from her to wean him of breastfeeding and total dependence in 2 years. And we told him, be grateful to me and your parents. To me is the ultimate return of you all. But if your parents impose on you to associate with me, Allah, things that you know to be nothing at all, then never give them obedience in this, keeping in mind to always be kind to them in this earthly life, and stay on the path of those repented and came back to me and followed Prophet Muhammad, then you all shall return to me and I shall inform you what you had been doing.
Ya bunayya innaha in taku mithqala habbatin min khardal fatakun fi sakhratin aw fi samawati aw fil ardi yati biha Allah إن الله لطيف خبير يا بني أقم الصلاة وأمر بالمعروف وانه عن المنكر واصبر على ما أصابك إن ذلك من عزم الأمور ولا تصعر خدك للناس ولا تمشي في الأرض مرحا إن الله لا يحب كل مختال فخور وقصد في مشيك واغضض من صوتك إن أنكر الأصوات لصوت الحمير.
Luqman went on saying to his son, My dear son, be aware that everything or deed, good or bad, even if it is the size of an atom, even if it is hidden in the hard layers of the rocks or in the vast layers of the heavens or in the dark depth of the earth, Allah is sure to bring it back for reckoning on that day. Verily, Allah is the knower of all secrets and He is all aware. My dear son, perform your prayers on time and advise people with good and forbid evil acts and be patient with what harm could happen to you. Truly, these advices are from what Allah orders you to do and among the matters of determination. Do not turn your face away in arrogance or pride from people when talking to them, and do not walk on earth between people in pride of yourself or possessions, as Allah does not like anyone who is too proud of himself or his beauty or possessions. Be humble and moderate in your walk and do not raise your voice. Talk gently. Surely the most disliked voices are the braying of the donkey.
أَلَمْ تَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَلَا هُدَى وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِيرٍ وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمُ اتَّبِعُوا مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ قَالُوا بَلْ نَتَّبِعُ مَا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهِ آبَاءَنَا أَوَلَوْ كَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ يَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَى عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ وَمَنْ يُسْلِمْ وَجَهَهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ فَقَدِ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى وَإِلَى اللَّهِ عَاقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ كُفْرُهُ إِلَيْنَا مَرْجِعُهُمْ فَنُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ نُمَتِّعُهُمْ قَلِيلًا ثُمَّ نَضْطَرُّهُمْ إِلَى عَذَابٍ غَلِيظٍ
O people, do you not see that Allah has made everything in the heavens and the earth for your benefit, and He bestowed on you His blessings, apparent and hidden? And among the people, some whom argue about Allah, although they do not have knowledge or guidance, nor an enlightening book to support what they say. When it said to them, Follow what Allah has sent down on His Prophet Muhammad, they will reply, No, but we follow what our forefathers worshipped. Is it so, even though the Satan has been calling them to the punishment of the blazing fire? Note, as if Satan is inviting them to his way and making them think they are right, and in fact Satan is leading them to the punishment of the hellfire. Whomever is submitting himself and his heart to Allah and does good deeds, then he indeed has held on a firm support that will lead him to paradise. And in the end, all matters shall return to Allah. He will reward the good and punish the bad. Whomever disbelieves, do not be sad or disappointed with him, O Prophet Muhammad, because you delivered the message and the warning. To us they shall return on the day of judgment, and we will inform them of what they did in their earthly life, and we will punish them for their disobedience. Verily, Allah is aware of what lies in their chests of disbelief and following Satan. We let them enjoy a little in this earthly life, and then when they return to us, then we will drag them to a heavy punishment.
وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ لله ما في السماوات والأرض إن الله هو الغني الحميد ولو أن ما في الأرض من شجرة أقلام والبحر يمده من بعده سبعة أبحر ما نفدت كلمات الله إن الله عزيز حكيم ما خلقكم ولا بعثكم إلا كنفس واحدة إن الله سميع بصير.
O Prophet, if you ask them who created the heavens and the earth, they would certainly say, Allah. Then you say, Praise be to Allah, that you people acknowledge that. Truly, most of the people do not know to reflect or consider on Allah's creation to be grateful to Him. All that exists in the heavens and the earth belongs to Allah. Indeed, it is Allah whom is free of all needs, worthy of every praise. If all the trees that are on the earth are made into pens, and the ocean converted into ink is supported by seven seas following it, to write Allah's words, then the pens and the ink will be finished before writing all His words, because His words are endless. Verily, Allah is the Almighty in His punishment and all-wise in all matters. In fact, the creation of all of you and the resurrection of all of you is like creating and resurrecting a single person. Verily, Allah is all-hearing, all-seeing.